Friends, welcome to Akul Mac Live. And as you know that the Indian origin or Indians are becoming the CEOs of the world global multinationals. And one particular news was more disturbing than the previous one. Well, I feel very happy about Indians actually acquiring the position of power. But I think there was another news coming from another Indian origin CEO of Better.com, who actually laid off hundreds of people over a Zoom call. So this is a very big global talking subject. To discuss this, to analyze this further, I am joined by a very eminent speaker from Singapore and the CEO of Career Zoom, Ms. Farida Charania. So let's welcome her.
Hi CK, and hello viewers. I hope everyone is doing very well. And things kind of start looking better next year. We are almost towards the fag end of 2021. Wow, where does this year go?
Well, Farida, I think the year just went by and there was a big dip in everybody's balance sheet. And there was a time to do a calibration when it comes to business. But I think more important that the way it was done by Better.com, the CEO invited certain selected people. If I remember correctly, there were 900 people on a Zoom call where all these 900 people were fired. So, and the year is not over yet, and 2022 has not yet started. So I think this kind of news is quite disturbing, especially during the lockdown and Corona period. What is your opinion about this?
I have been listening to this, hearing this. So listening because people are discussing, hearing because you hear them on media, reading because people are discussing this online. And it is a big discussion because while, you know, often CEOs of Indian origin who surface as the ones who have done very, very well, they are leading world's largest companies, and all of us who are Indian origin people, but you know, a lot of us don't live in India, but we are Indian origin and we feel very proud. But when you feel proud, there are instances which kind of make you take a step back. Now, very recently, a digital mortgage company by the name of Better.com, which is a startup, had this huge firing exercise, and all over Zoom by the CEO. Now, this is a company which is, the valuation of about 7 billion. They have very recently received a 750 million, and they are backed by SoftBank. So they have raised a round which is close to 750 million, and it's a deal to, you know, go through a SPAC. So what exactly is kind of happening, and what, just led to this? And even if it led to this, was there a better way it could have been done? So I actually saw the video of the CEO Vishal Garg, who said that this is the second time he's doing something like this in his career. The earlier time when he did it, he cried and he hopes to do better this time. But it was firing 900 people all over a Zoom call, which probably is not the best for optics. You can fire 900 people, but there has to be a better way to deliver the news. It could have been done better. So, while I don't think my opinion matters that much, but since I'm talking, I feel it could have been done in a more empathetic way. It could have been, not such a spectacle. I don't know if there was a reason to do it in such a way. But there are a few things which kind of jump out from this whole interaction. One, there definitely was a better way to do it. It could have been, a lot more engaged. I had a friend recently mentioning, if you can hire people over Zoom, you can also fire them over Zoom. I said, yeah, that is, if you make 900 calls and hire 900 people over Zoom, you should be making 900 calls and firing 900 people, one by one, each of them separately, by giving them a reason as to why you're letting them go. Because it's not about hiring people, you don't hire 900 people at once over one Zoom call. So you can't really fire 900 people at the same time over one Zoom call. But, you know, and this is a company which was actually ranked as LinkedIn's top startups list, you know, and Fortune's best small and medium enterprises workplaces in New York. So it's a little bit shocking. Vishal Garg just happens to be of Indian origin, but if anyone has done this, it wouldn't shock me lesser.
Well, Farida, I think I respect your thoughts and your comments, but let me add my own experience to this. I used to work for a multinational which is among the top 10. I don't want to take the name here, but during the normal times, you know, this is like among the top 10 companies globally, and during the normal times, 10% of the people would leave the company or they'll get fired every month. So I mean, they had about 200,000 people working globally, and 10% people leaving them globally every month. By the time it is 8th month in a year, the entire company has renewed itself. So there were companies like that during the good times, where the firing was the norm and hiring was just filling the gap, you know. So I don't think it's a very big deal. You know, you can fire people whichever way you want. This time it's a news because it's done on Zoom, probably first time. But I don't see a big problem firing 900 people or even 2,000 people, because this has been going on for some time. We keep hearing that TCS has laid off 2,000 people. This has been going on. I think, what is the big surprise here?
It is a surprise because, more than surprise, there is to every action, there is a what and a how. The what is fine. You know, laying off 10% of the company staff is not a big deal. It happens many times. And in fact, during this whole pandemic situation, we have seen the likes of Airbnb, the likes of LinkedIn laying off people. And that is fine because, yes, you do understand that, you know, it kind of creates an impact. It's no longer sustainable for the company, or maybe they are not adding value. But how it was done is a question. How it was done is a question of discussion here. That's the premise I'm very uncomfortable with, because, you know, as a leader, you are not setting the right example. So you are basically setting an example of everything that's not right. That it's okay to be despotic. It's okay to run your company in a very, in a manner where it's really despotic, that you kind of rule. Telling 900 people over a Zoom call, generalizing everything and telling them that some of you have been working only 2 hours and you've been billing for 8 hours. How does that actually add value? You are creating a scare. You are creating a scare even for people to come to you in future. And the people who are already there, now they are rethinking that, okay, loyalty, working hard, everything is fine. But tomorrow, if they want to fire me, they are not going to think too much about it. So it kind of really doesn't go well. It, you know, there would be people. So if they are firing 900 people, they are probably, you know, hiring another 900 to fill the gaps, because it's 900 people laying off is not a big deal. Hiring 900 people is not a big deal. But how are they going to attract talent in future? Like you just said, that, you know, in a large company, in 8 to 10 months, the whole workforce has renewed itself. And it's very common. It happens. But how are they going to, you know, actually attract the future talent? How are they going to make sure that they will always have, you know, enough manpower to continue their business? And this is a very, this is a world where everything is very perceptive. We are not in the 90s now where, you know, a graduate was very sought after. There were so many, you know, there were many jobs and less graduates, so a college degree made sense. But today, a college degree really doesn't make that much sense. It's not setting you apart from others, because, you know, all of those people who graduated, then they actually made sure that their children graduated. The ones who didn't graduate, their children also would have a degree now. So you have less jobs and more graduates. So how is it setting you apart? And the young people today, they don't want to go and, you know, work for a company where their time is not respected. I think we grew up in a very different time. We basically, you know, went to work and we thought whatever happens with us is fine because that's how it's supposed to be. But today's generation is not going to do that. The people who are in their, you know, mid-20s, late-20s, early-30s, they are not going to take this lying down. It's kind of, so I'm just trying to, you know, express a point as to, is this a good thing? You know, it's nothing to do with an Indian CEO. That is just coincidental. That's just a byproduct of this whole thing. The person happens to be Indian. But what about the entire culture of the company? What about the value system? What if, you know, some younger aspirational leaders actually think that is the right way? How are we going? How is the world getting so transactional? That is my question.
Well, Farida, I fully agree with you. In fact, I'm on the same plane as you are. And let me clarify that when I said that the 10% of the company was getting was moving on, either getting fired for some reason or just moving on. The work environment in that company was really, really bad because you have zero trust. There was no trust on people and they could not simply work together. I mean, the company used to give hefty target that the starting work order should be $1 million minimum. Below that, they are not interested. So you can imagine the $1 million are not flying every day like an aeroplane and landing into your lap. And that was the work order, you know, first work order. So that, those are the kind of environment that we were exposed to, and definitely nobody lasted for very long because there was a very high deficit of trust among each other. But I think I again agree with you that the when you actually fire on Zoom, and next time when anybody gets a call to join a Zoom call from this CEO, the chances are people will start worrying. Hey, what is going to happen? So I think there you're absolutely bang on because you're not giving the right message that if the CEO calls me over Zoom, the chances are 90% probability I'll get fired today. Isn't it, Farida?
Yeah. I think, okay, I never try to look at things as black and white, especially, you know, when it comes to such heavy decisions as layoffs or, but, you know, this is an exception. Because I'm very saddened to see something so sensitive executed without a heart, soul, or empathy. It's precisely an example as to how not to lead. I think, you know, leaders who lead in this way, they really need to do better. Because you don't want to be a leader whose staff actually fears the call, like you said. Because, you know, in earlier times, or even before this incident, if the CEO is inviting you to a Zoom call, you know, as a staff, you are actually very happy because you feel that you are important enough to be in this meeting. But imagine these 900 people who came into this meeting without even kind of, you know, expecting anything like this, and they were just let go. So now, yes, you're right. I mean, in future, employees of this company would actually fear. And, you know, if there are people setting such examples in other ways of their behavior, then those companies also have to kind of watch out how they execute things, because this is just a very lame way to execute anything. I don't have a better word, but I think it's not a nice way to do anything, because end of the day, we are all humans. It's okay to let go people. It's fine if the company no longer needs their services, because employees also leave all the time. It is just how this was executed and how it's actually very quickly become, you know, a topic of discussion. I think it's been a week and everybody's talking about it.
Well, I wouldn't worry too much about this person being an Indian origin, because every fifth citizen of the world is an Indian today. So they would eventually end up heading some organizations or majority of the organizations globally. So I don't see that as a big issue, but definitely I fully agree with you that such decisions can be done in a different manner. Maybe you can change the work orders, basically, in terms of hiring, saying that, hey, you will only work not on employment but on a contract. Then it becomes a lot easier. So I think the people should think of, if they want to have more flexibility in terms of managing manpower. But I think the moot question is, what was running in this gentleman's mind? You know, he is such an experienced person. What are his compulsion? Maybe his management, his board was pressing him to show some positive sides in the company. So we need to also discuss about that, Farida.
I think, look, a lot of it is going to be assumptions, because we really don't know. When you actually just Google this particular issue, there are so many things. I mean, the first 50 pages, if you can go that far, is full of this. And there will be, probably opinions on this. There are different assumptions on this. But what I understand based on facts that this CEO is actually fighting multiple lawsuits at the moment about, the entities that he controls of improper, even fraudulent activity at two prior business ventures, and of misappropriating few tens of millions of dollars. He's taken a huge bonus last year. So he's probably, a very good businessman, but his perception, the way he operates his business, is not something that is, very much right home about. I mean, this is one Indian origin CEO I wouldn't want to take, any kind of pride on. But I think it's just, it's an example of not just this particular individual. It's an example of how frustrated leaders are today. It's very difficult, because some of them can actually blow the lid. And this has probably happened. Maybe this person is under a lot of pressure from the investors, and he probably thinks that if he has to fire 900 people personally, one by one, it would be after Christmas. He wants to have a good Christmas. You don't know. You really don't know, because we can only talk about it as in jest. This actually gives me an analogy that if you forget password on your email, do you do forgot password, or you start banging all the keys on the keyboard thinking that something will click? So maybe he just did forgot password, and he just kind of did, okay, all of you are going off today, and I'm taking the day off after this. So maybe he just decided it was better. This was not a soft blow. It's a hard blow, but it happens at once, and then the thing is done. It sets an example for others who are taking it easy. There are many ways to look at it. I really don't, have any advice for anyone. But when, we are discussing this, I just have opinion, which I'm not sure if anybody cares. But if our viewers are watching, I would just like to say one thing, that how and what is very important. What you do is fine, but how you do it is a lot more important. And how you execute stuff is a lot more important.
Well, Farida, I think you made all the points, which are very, very relevant for everyone, all professionals. So thank you for joining our show today and expressing your opinion about this incident in our business life. Viewers, if you have any questions, you can shoot it out, or you can write it to us, and we will make that answered by Farida in our future shows. But Farida, thank you very much for joining. And any last words you would have for our viewers?
I think we are approaching end of 2021, and we all hope that 2022 would be better. There are a few things which, I would like to say to people who are watching, that things will get better. The pandemic is not going to go away as quickly as we would like it to. But what will happen is that because of vaccines, lives will be saved a lot more. So we will not see the bloodbath that we have seen in the last 2 years, hopefully. Because of advances in medical science, it will be treated better. So it might become like a seasonal flu. And thirdly, it's an acquired immunity. Either people who have got infected and recovered, they already have an antibody structure in their body, or people who have got vaccinated, they have created the antibody. So it's like, you know, you train yourself on a bike on the road. You cycle on the road and you train yourself. So that's, you know, getting infected and recovering. Or you train yourself on a stationary bike, you know, in a stationary place in your gym or your home, but you're still building the, you know, immunity for that matter by the vaccines. So you are still training your muscles, you are still building immunity. So I would say that, yes, we should look forward to better times. And my best wishes to all our viewers. Have a very, very good rest of the year, whatever is left. And we'll see you in the next year, in the new year. So happy holidays.
Happy holidays to you, Farida, and thank you very much. Well, the entire internet is filled with training on empathy, people friendliness, you know, all those kind of things, but then people don't learn. I think this incident proves it. Friends, if you have any comments, you write in, send in your comments, or send us email with your suggestions. The email will be given in the end of the video, and we will reply to you as much as so much as so possible. But for now, let me say goodbye, and I will catch you in the next one.